Sabbath school time.
Enjoy your time with us. Hurry, you don't want to miss it. And log on and share. Just remember to bring a friend.
Good morning and happy Sabbath, boys and girls. I am so glad that you decided to tune in to another episode of It's Sabbath School Time. I am your host, Auntie Simone, and I'm so glad that you are here to join us. Now, we are going to get on the way after I let you know that you can find your Sabbath School lessons at www.gracelink.net. There you will find, like I said, all the Sabbath School lessons and other resources to help you learn more about Jesus. Now, as we move forward, we're going to have Jessica Dunn, who will do the welcome, and she attends the Portmore Seventh-day Adventist Church. After that, we will hear from Micah Headlam, who attends the Ginger Peace Seventh-day Adventist Church, and he will be doing the opening prayer.
I've got the joy down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart. I've got the joy down in my heart. Where? Down in my heart to stay. Welcome, boys and girls. Welcome to Sabbath School.
Good morning, everybody. Dear Jesus, thank you for waking me up this morning. Thank you for everything you have done for us. All of the people that are in the hospital, please pray for them and make them better. All the people in the church, help them and keep them safe. Anybody that is on the road right now, please keep them safe from all harms and danger. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Welcome to another episode of What's Inside Auntie Simone's Fruit and Vegetable Basket. This week we are going to focus on the pear, not the avocado. I'm talking about the other kind of fruit called a pear. Did you know that there are over 3,000 types of pears in the world? A standard size pear tree can grow 12 meters, which is about 40 feet tall, if not pruned, and have a spread of 9 to 12 meters, which is about 30 to 40 feet wide. Pears are one of the highest fiber fruits, offering 6 grams per medium-sized fruit, helping you meet your daily requirement of 25 to 30 grams. Pears contain a fair amount of vitamin C, K, B2, B3, B6. And if you are an expectant mommy, hey, it contains folate. Pears aren't too shabby in the mineral department either. They contain calcium, magnesium, potassium, copper, and manganese. Okay, boys and girls, don't forget to run out and try your new fruit, a pear. Okay, if you eat them already, continue enjoying them. Auntie Simone loves the Asian pears. All right, well, I look forward for you coming back next Sabbath to learn what else is inside Auntie Simone's fruit and vegetable basket. Bye. Our special feature section today will be done by Stacia Sinclair, who attends the Portmore Seventh-day Adventist Church. Boys and girls, give her your undivided attention.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. My name is Stacia. Today, I will be telling you the reasons why I praise God. God is awesome, magnificent, miracle-working God. When you pray, He answers your prayer. If you pray to Him for something, He will come true for you. God is very good. There's a song that says, God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to me. Isn't God good?
Well, it's time for our sing-along, and like I always tell you, get your instruments or get your voice ready, all right, to sing along or play along with them. At this time, we're going to hear from Nahika and Rochelle Summers, who attend the Lauderhill Seventh-day Adventist Church, and they'll be doing song number one. Then song number two will be done by, and I believe siblings as well, which is Ethan, who's on the piano, and Joshua, who will be singing, and their last names are Stewart, and they attend the Handsome Place Seventh-day Adventist Church in New York. Then we'll hear from Jeremy Dunn, who will be playing his recorder. Yes, and he attends the Portmore Seventh-day Adventist Church. All right, listen or sing along with them.
My feet are tired from the running. My strength is gone for overcoming. My lips are silent, I don't know what to pray. So I'll wait for you. My eyes have seen your hand deliver. My heart remembers you, my help and my defender. My will runs dry, but I know the taste of rain. So I'll wait for you. Here I am, I'm reaching out. I need you always, oh, I need you now. I'm coming close, so we can stay hand in hand until we stand face to face. I still believe in new beginnings. The battle rages, but I still believe you're winning. The night will bend to the light that's breaking through. So I'll wait for you. Here I am, I'm reaching out. I need you always, oh, I need you now. I'm coming close, so we can stay hand in hand until we stand face to face. Face to face, you are the light here. When bond is braved and darkness dies, face to face, you are the end of fear. Who you are brings heaven here. Oh, who you are brings heaven here. Yeah. Here I am, I'm reaching now. I need you always, oh, I need you now. I'm coming close, so we can stay hand in hand until we stand face to face. Hand in hand until we stand face to face. Hand in hand till we stand face to face.
My name is Ethan.
And my name is Joshua.
You surround me with the song.
It's time now for our Sabbath school lessons, and we are going to hear from Auntie Frenita, who will be doing the primary and the kindergarten Sabbath school lessons. Then after that, we will hear from Anicia Davis, who attends the Spanish Town Seventh-day Adventist Church, and she will be doing the junior lesson review.
Hello, boys and girls. This is Aunt Frenita, and I have a wonderful story for you called A Floating Zoo. Today's memory verse is from Psalms 48, verse 1. Great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. The message for today's story is we thank God for keeping His promises. What do you do when it rains day after day after day? The Bible tells about Noah and 40 days of rain. What do you think Noah did? Noah, his wife, and his three sons, and their wives rested safely inside the ark. So did the animals. God Himself had closed and sealed the door to the ark. For 7 days they waited, and then the rain began, just as God said it would. Rain poured from the sky. It thundered onto the ark's roof. But Noah and his family, the people who loved God, they were safe. The rain poured down all day, every day. Soon water covered all the flat land, and the ark began to float. The rain continued to pour down all day, every day. But everyone inside the ark was safe. Noah and his family thanked God for keeping His promise. It was the first thing that they did every morning and the last thing they did at night. Every day they sang songs of praise to the Lord. And still the rain poured down, all day, every day. Noah checked on the animals often. Some snored softly in their cages. They breathed slowly in and out. Others nibbled on the food God had told Noah to put into the ark. How much longer is it going to rain? Asked one of Noah's sons. It feels as if it's been raining forever. Noah smiled. For 40 days, he answered. God said that it would rain for 40 days. But don't worry, 40 days is not forever. And still the rain poured down, all day, every day. Finally, water covered the tops of the very tallest mountains. No land could be seen. Then God stopped the rain. It had rained for exactly 40 days, just as God had promised. Slowly, the water began to go down. One day, the ark bumped the side of a mountain, and that's where it settled. Noah waited for many, many days. Then he sent out one of the black ravens. The big bird soared across the water, but it found no place to land and rest, so it came back to the ark. 7 days later, Noah sent one of the doves free, but it found no place to land either, so it flew back to the ark. Noah waited 7 more days. Then he let the little dove out again and watched it fly away. And Noah waited. He waited and he watched. Finally, the dove returned to the ark. This time it had an olive leaf in its beak. Things are beginning to grow again, Noah exclaimed. 7 days later, Noah sent the dove free once more. This time, the little bird did not return. Then Noah knew that the waters had dried up. And Noah knew that God had kept His promise. The flood was over, and they were safe.
This podcast was brought to you by GraceLink.net and Studio El Piso. For more children's resources, please visit GraceLink.net.
Hello, everyone. It's Aunt Frenita, and we're studying Lesson 7, Help Wanted. The message for this week is, I worship God when I use my abilities to do His work. The memory verse is from Ephesians chapter 6, verse 7. Serve wholeheartedly as if you were serving the Lord, not men. Ah Ming and Mei Li huddled in front of Dad's iPad. They were watching a video of someone on the screen build a great-looking origami house. They followed the directions step by step, and eventually they had a great-looking house too. Some things need a pattern, directions, or a plan. God knew plans were important when the Israelites started to build the tabernacle, a sanctuary for Him. The Israelites found it hard to describe their feelings of joy and happiness. God loved them so much that He wanted a home in their camp. They called God's tabernacle home His sanctuary. They could talk to God anytime, just as we can. But God knew it was important for the Israelites to have a place where they could meet with Him. The Israelites had lived in Egypt a long time. They knew more about Egyptian gods than they knew about the living God who had rescued them. It would be very easy for them to forget God. The tabernacle was God's way of reminding them that He was there all the time. First, the Israelites collected the materials they would need. They happily gave their gifts. Everyone gave the best things they owned for God's home. They brought silver, gold, and brass, as well as the best material and animal skins. In fact, they gave so much that God told Moses, "Tell them to stop. We have enough." Everyone wanted to help with the building project, from the oldest to the youngest. Everyone wanted to do something. God wanted His house to be very special for the people. He gave plans to Moses for the workers. He described everything in great detail. Soon it was time to choose who was going to do what. God talked to Moses, "Building my sanctuary is the most important thing you will do. I have chosen two special people to help. Bezalel and Oholiab come from different tribes. Bezalel is Uri's son, Hur's grandson, and comes from the tribe of Judah. Oholiab comes from the tribe of Dan. He is Ahisamach's son. I have blessed these men in a special way. They will be able to work with all kind of crafts. They can follow the plans I have given you. No one will be able to make things as well as they can. You will need many other skilled people to help. Everyone who works on the building will receive an extra blessing from me. I will make their talents and abilities much better than before. Remember to make all the things I showed you. I gave you the plans for the meeting tent and everything inside, including the ark and its special cover. When the ark is finished, put the Ten Commandments inside." The Israelites worked together to build God's tabernacle home. Happiness filled their hearts as they worked. Just as God promised, He blessed their talents and abilities. Our church is like the Israelites' tabernacle. We come here to worship God and praise Him for everything He does for us. When we use our talents and abilities for God, He will bless them and improve them.
This podcast is read by Frenita Buddy for GraceLink.net. Created and produced by Falvo Fowler. Post-produced by Faith Toe at Studio El Piso. The theme music is by Clayton Kinney. For more information, please visit GraceLink.net.
Happy Sabbath, Church. Lesson 7, Power Text. He answered, Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength and with all your mind. And love your neighbor as yourself. Luke chapter 10, verse 27. Church, have you ever moved into a neighborhood and you didn't feel welcome? Well, how did that feel? Jesus gave us an entirely new definition for the word neighbor in one of his stories. Jesus sat on the hillside teaching as usual. A lot of different people listened to him. Some came because he gave them hope. Some came because he helped them understand the love of God. Others came because they doubted him and wanted to test him. Today, a lawyer was in the crowd. He was one who wanted to test Jesus, so he asked, "Teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" Jesus, who could understand this lawyer's heart, answered his question with a question. He wanted everyone to hear and understand. What is written in the law? How do you read it? The lawyer smiled proudly and said, Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength and with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. You have answered correctly, Jesus responded. Do this and you will live. Thank you.
Sabbath school lessons are all done now, and now we are going to have song number 4. And song number 4 will be done by Alexandria Smith, and she attended the Portmore Seventh-day Adventist Church. End of the program at this time, and we're going to have our closing prayer, which will be done by Khalil Grant, who attend the Portmore Seventh-day Adventist Church. Then we'll have our goodbye, which will be done by Jordan Groves, and he attend the Brayton Seventh-day Adventist Church.
Let us pray. Dear Lord, thank you for the sake. Thank you for giving us life, Lord. Thank you for forgiving us for all our misdeeds. And thank you for giving us the chance of being with you over and over again. We hope that we won't waste this chance for you. And we hope that we get into heaven with you, Lord. We thank you for everything you have done for us. Thank you for bringing us life. Thank you for giving us our families. Thank you for giving us food to eat. And thank you for just everything you have done for us, Lord. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
Remember, God loves you. Goodbye, everybody. Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye, everybody. Goodbye. Goodbye. Please come again. Please come again. Goodbye, everybody. Goodbye. Goodbye.
Hello, parents, guardians, and churches. Would you like to have your child participate in the It's Sabbath School Time program? They can do the welcome, prayer, sing, or play an instrument, say the goodbye, or do a short testimony, praise, poem, short children's story, or skit for the special feature section. Please send your videos to itssabbathschooltimepsda@gmail.com. Again, it's sabbathschooltimepsda@gmail.com. Boys and girls, we use this time to say thank you to God for allowing us to have this program. Our thank you also go to NCU TV and NCU FM, your education and wellness station. We say thank you to the following participants in our program today. Jessica did our welcome. Micah did our opening prayer. Stasia did the special feature. Nahika and Rochelle did song number one. Ethan and Joshua did song number two. Jeremy, song number three. Our junior lesson review was done by Anicia, and song number four was done by Alexandra. Closing prayer was done by Khalil, and our goodbye was done by Jordan. The Sabbath School Time team leaders are Jackie Morrison, Children and Adolescent Ministry Leader, Sylvina Williams, a Sabbath School teacher, yours truly, Simone Harris, Sabbath School teacher and producer, and Micaiah Morgan, our assistant producer.
Well, boys and girls, here's what I have for you to do for me this week, all right? I want to hear from you because I want you to be a part of the program. So don't forget to submit your videos and or an email letting us know what does Jesus mean to you, all right? Don't forget to let me know what does Jesus mean to you. Send us the email at itssabbathschooltimepsda@gmail.com. That is, it's Sabbath School Time, P as in Paul, S, D as in dog, A@gmail.com. And I look forward to hearing from you. Have a wonderful Sabbath. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and share the program. All right, bye.